Hello and welcome everyone. Today we are going to start with the preparation of ketones. In this video we will see three methods which are just the same as we have done for aldehydes. If you haven't seen the previous videos on aldehydes, just go through it, because the mechanism of how the reactions take place has already been discussed in those videos. So these methods which I'm going to discuss right now will be discussed very quickly because they are just the same as that for aldehydes. Let's begin with the first method. The first method by which I can prepare ketones is oxidation of secondary alcohols. Now here we will see what are secondary alcohols. This point is clear with everybody. Still we'll have a look at what is secondary alcohol. If the OH, that is the hydroxyl group, is attached to the secondary carbon atom, the carbon which is attached to two carbon atoms is called as the secondary carbon atom. So this is my secondary alcohol, and I'm going to oxidize this using a very milder oxidizing agent. So we have seen so many examples in the previous reactions also. So the same, we are going to use pyridinium chlorochromate or chromic anhydride. The job of these two reagents is that they are very milder one. They will not cause complete oxidation, but only partial oxidation. If we use very strong oxidizing agents, we will get complete oxidation. Now what is going to happen here is we are going to remove the hydrogen atom from the hydroxyl and also the alpha hydrogen atom, this one. So this is my alpha carbon atom, the one which is attached to the functional group. So just remove these two hydrogen atoms and what you get is your answer. Look at this, so you can see that we have got the ketone. So any such reaction you all can accomplish, like for example, if I just remove this and I put any group over here, for example, I'm putting this benzene ring over there. So this is also again a secondary alcohol, and your answers are again going to be the same. So it's a very simple technique. So that was your first method. The second method which we will see is dehydrogenation. Dehydrogenation of secondary alcohol. So it's more or less the synonym of oxidation. Both are same. Dehydrogenation means removal of hydrogen. Removal of hydrogen means oxidation only. Addition of oxygen is also oxidation. So it's the same, children, as we have seen. Dehydration of secondary alcohols. Once again, you can take any secondary alcohol of your choice. Like for example, I'm taking this one. Butane 2-ol, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it is butane 2-ol. Now this point is important for us to understand that this method is only suitable for volatile alcohols which have a very low boiling point. Okay, so having a boiling point less than 100 degrees Celsius, so we'll say you're volatile, and we can easily evaporate those alcohols. And the reagent, as we know, is copper at 573 Kelvin. So this is also important for us to remember in the exam, the temperature conditions. Same mechanism, we are going to knock out the hydroxyl H, we are going to knock out the alpha H, and we get a secondary alcohol converted to a ketone like this. You can see that we have got from butane 2-ol, we have got butane 2-ol. Look at this. So from butane 2-ol, we have got butane 2-ol as the compound. Let's see the third method. The third method is from hydrocarbons, namely alkenes and alkynes. If you start from alkenes, that is the double bonded compounds, they are going to give you products which can be aldehydes or ketones. And the technique which we are going to use, we have already discussed, is ozonolysis. So we'll just take a quick reaction over here. So alkenes, will take any alkene like this, CH3CH double bond CH2, for example. I've taken this one. Let's make it more bigger, so we'll have something like this. And I'll have to attach methyl groups over here, because if I put H over here, I'm going to get aldehyde. So I'll just remove this H. Now this alkene, if you have taken, which is a tetra substituted alkene, you can see the double bonded carbon atoms. If you focus, they are attached to four substituents, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So this alkene is going to be called as a tetra substituted alkene, and we are going to add the reagent ozone, which is an oxidizing agent. And we had seen last time that we get an ozonide, which is a cyclic intermediate. So it's very simple to draw this ozonide. Just focus here, we'll get CH3 CCH3, bond. These two bonds are going to break, and the same thing we are going to write again. So CH3 CH3, and we get the formation of an ozonide. Now see, it's, you can just draw it this way also. Look at this. So I can just draw it this way. So this compound is the ozonide, which is a cyclic intermediate, and now we are just going to break it, reduce it, that means by using zinc and water. And this is the way the bond is going to break, and we'll get ZnO. Okay, Zn and O, and this is going to be CH3C CH3O CH3C CH3O from both the sides. So we get ketones, CH3C CH3 double bond O, plus same thing from the RHS, will get CCH3CH3. So children, this was not a very difficult method, since we had already done this in the previous video for aldehydes. So also we have understood that ozonolysis of alkenes can give you a variety of products. They can give you aldehydes or they can give you ketones, both depending upon the substituted alkene. Because if now here I have taken substituted alkene, so I've got ketone. Let's see the next method, that is from alkynes.